Dear students, a very warm welcome to you all to our SRPU college for the program of PU, pre-university program. So, you all have completed successfully your secondary school until SSLC or 10th standard. Now, you are entering into a new phase of your education life. So, welcome you all for pre-university college. So, you have studied various branches of science in your lower classes, of course physics, chemistry, biology, right? So these are the branches that you have come across, and I, being the lecturer of biology, I welcome you all to biology department. I am Sunil Dutt Joshi. I basically teach botany, one of the branches of biology. So on a welcome note to biology, let us have an introductory session in biology today. As you are seeing this colorful slide, you may be wondering, why is this so colorful? It is just so colorful just as the subject is. So yes, biology, as you very well know, it is the study of living organisms, life and living organisms, and of course life is so colorful, so joyful, and that is what is the study of life, that is biology. So you have come across, you have understood what is biology basically. So biology is the, it's a branch of science that deals with the study of life and living organisms, right? So when we say living organisms, it can be ranging from smallest of the microorganisms and until the largest and most complex of all the organisms, right? And just for our convenience, we have two branches in, we have made two branches of biology, basic branches as botany and zoology. So that is what, so we are seeing here. So biology is a natural science. See, natural science, it is concerned with the study of life and living organisms. Various characteristics of living organism we are going to study, right? The basic characteristics, or what we say, life processes. So these characteristics which define life. If at all, if you say there is life, you will have to find out these characteristics are there or not. Like it can be growth, it can be reproduction, it can be nutrition, it can be what, other various processes like respiration, maybe response to stimuli, right? So all these are basic life defining processes or life defining properties. So these things we will understand, and as I told you, it is broadly, the subject is broadly classified into botany and zoology. Botany is the plant science, it is the study of plants, and zoology is the animal science, it is the branch of biology that deals with the study of animals, right? So branches of biology, apart from botany and zoology, there are other various branches of biology. Like, see, there were so many different topics under biology, and because the research field in biology is continuously growing, and it has become all these different topics of biology, all these small topics of biology, so now they have to be identified as branches, separate branches of biology. And apart from botany and zoology, we classify so many other branches of biology under two categories once again, as basic branches of biology and applied branches of biology. Let us see what are those, what branches of biology are. See, applied biology and basic biology. Applied biology means what? Basic biology means what? See, only to understand the theory of biology, that means to only to have the theoretical knowledge of biology, is the study of basic biology, right? And after understanding the, after what is that, taking the knowledge of basic biology, and that knowledge can be applied to get some yield from the organisms or maybe the biological product, right? So for example, by understanding the biology of a cow, we will understand, or we will plan how to extract maximum milk from the cow. or by understanding the mechanisms of a crop plant, like how well it grows in what kind of environmental condition. This is basic biology of that particular plant, right? And after understanding this, we will think of increasing the yield from that crop plant. So this is applied branch of biology. This is applied biology. So here we have got, so there are so many branches here, like forestry, morphology, physiology, embryology, taxonomy, ecology, biogeography, genetics, evolution, paleontology, molecular biology. All of these can be considered under what? The basic biology subjects or basic biology branches. Apart from these, we have got economic biology, animal husbandry, poultry, agriculture, horticulture, forestry, fisheries, veterinary science, medicine science, and also biotechnology, microbiology. All these are applied sciences of biology or applied branches of biology. So it is simple. So whatever the theoretical knowledge of life we gain in the basic biology, we will apply that knowledge to extract maximum yield of that biological product. So that is what we will learn in the applied biological aspects, right? So of course, various, many of these branches of both, some of the applied biology sciences and also most of the basic biological sciences, you are going to study in the 2-year program of pre-university, right? You are going to study about ecology, you will study about morphology of plants, you will study about anatomy of plants, morphology of different types of animals, animals anatomy also, physiology of the animals, physiology of human beings, physiology of plants. So various basic biological sciences you are going to learn. Apart from that, you will also learn about some part of microbiology and also biotechnology and also plant breeding techniques, animal breeding techniques. So like that, various animal husbandry or applied biological sciences also you are going to learn about. And why to study biology? See, why it is very important for us, why a branch of biology is very important for you to understand, is because, so let us try to answer this question. Why to study biology? What is the importance of studying biology? So, of course, by studying biology, it will let you understand the nature surrounding us, the environment surrounding us, and to be familiar with it. See, there is a very common and famous saying there. So it says that nature is not our own. We are a part of nature. That means human beings are also a kind of animals that come under the animal kingdom. You have understood this in your lower classes, right? So being a part of nature, is it not our concern to understand our nature better? So if you are living in your house, if you live in your home, only when you know which place has got which things, or which things have been kept at which places, only then you can live comfortably at your home. Only after understanding the very nature of your surroundings. So that is the same thing applicable even for an organism which lives in this environment, that is human beings, right? So the very understanding of the nature surrounding us can be done by studying biology. The second point here says that know about plants and their importance in the nature and in our lives. See, knowingly or unknowingly, we Indians and our ancestors, we have got a practice of using so many plants in our daily diet. For example, you can take the example of turmeric or mustard or curry leaves, like, and also aloe vera, which can be used today in the TV ads. You are seeing so much of aloe vera as a skin protectant or a cosmetic, etc., etc. But we Indians are using this since time immemorial. Tulsi, right, and also neem. So all these are highly medicinally important plants. So only today we are knowing about all these things, but our ancestors knew this since time immemorial. And by studying biology, you can know more about the plants. Plants can be really very good friends if you take them seriously, right? So you will know the importance of plants, maybe medicinally, maybe ecologically, right? So what is the importance of plants in the nature and in our lives? So to understand that, so biology is very important. Then So biology also lets us know about animals and their importance and in the nature and in our lives. See, animals, of course, animals, they are pet animals for all of us. Animals are very adorable, right? And animals today, in today's world, you can see more than humans, animals have got more humanity. Humans are losing the humanity, right? And animals are gaining the humanity because of their humane nature. So apart from that, see, in order to know more about our pet animals which are surrounding us, right? So to understand their behaviors, to understand their physiology, to understand their anatomy, right? So, and how to interact with them, what is their importance in our lives and in the nature. So to understand all about the animals, so we will have to study biology. That is why biology is important. Apart from this, biology is also important to know about our own body, our own health, how to maintain our health, how to keep up the good health. So this is also very important, isn't it? So understanding our body is the very important aspect of our life. So no matter whether you are a student of biology or not, it is very important for you to know about your body, at least some basic aspects about the body, right? So like doing yoga or exercising daily, right? So having healthy life practices, having a healthy food style, lifestyle, all these things. Why to follow all these things? How our body responses responses to various conditions of environment, how different foods can influence on the body, how body reacts physiologically, what are actually, what is the need of our body actually, right? So all these things, to know more about your body, what is important? Biology is important, because in biology, in PU1 and PU2 biology, you will come across most of the relevant aspects of human physiology. You will study about digestion, you will study about respiration in the human beings, circulation in the human beings, about the nervous system you are going to learn, about the hormonal systems, enzymatic systems, reproductive systems, right? Excretory systems. So you are going to learn all of this. And this gives at least some amount of understanding of our body. Apart from this, so very importantly, to have a concern for the environment. So it is very important for you to have a concern about our environment, our nature. So only when you nurture the nature, only when we nurture the nature will nurture us. It is as simple as that, right? So if you are antagonistic, or if you are willing to harm the nature, then nature will definitely harm you, isn't it? So that is why, so what is the importance of the environment and how to nurture it, how to look after it, how to care for it, right? All these aspects you are going to learn about, having concern about the nature or the environment under a branch of biology, which you are also going to learn in the PU called ecology. So you are going to learn about various aspects of ecology, like about organisms and its environment, how the interaction between the environment and organisms takes place, and how do organisms respond to various different environmental conditions. So all these things we are going to study in this particular topic. So one more important question. See, after understanding what is the importance of biology, you may be having a big doubt. Right now, after completing your 10th standard, you may be having a big doubt. What after 10th standard? Whether I should go in the science stream or art stream or commerce stream, or I should take up the technical stream like diploma or something else. So what to do? So which will lead me where? So this will be the big question. And of course, when you are joining PU science year, I think that question is already sorted out. But definitely similar questions will arise in the future, in the very near future, that is after completion of your 2 years course in PU. So what career opportunities are available for me after completing 2 years of PU course by taking biology as one of the subjects? That means if you choose PCMB combination in your PU, what career opportunities, what further courses you are going to be offering later. So all that things, let us try to discuss here. So this is the wide scope of biology. So after 12th PCMB, you can opt for many courses like this. So obviously medical sciences, you can go for medical sciences like MBBS, BDS. MBBS, of course, it is, you are all familiar with. BDS, Bachelor of Dental Science. BHMS, Bachelor of Homeopathic Medical Sciences. BAMS, Bachelor of Ayurvedic Medical Sciences. Paramedical courses like lab technician courses are there, and also anesthetist paramedical courses are there, and also B Pharma, D Pharma, various paramedical courses are there, right? So you can choose all these things, or you can also choose BBSc. I would like to put BBSc, BSc Agri, BSc Forestry, BSc Horticulture, Home Science, and BFSc. All these under one category. BBSc, BSc AG, that is Agriculture, Forestry, Horticulture, and BFSc, and also even the Home Science. See, all these courses are actually applied biological sciences, where you are going to learn about the veterinary science or agricultural science, forestry science, horticultural science, right, home science, and also, again, this is also forestry. This is repeated. Forestry and BFSC both are same. So why I'm considering all these under one category is because, so you know that there is an entrance after completion of your PUC that is called KCET, Karnataka Common Entrance Test, for various courses which will offer you good jobs, right? So they are called as professional courses. So in order to take an entry into these courses, you will have to write this entrance exam KCET, and after clearing that exam, 50% of your score in the CET will be considered, and that will be summed up with 50% of your score in PUC, that is a final examination, board examination, PUC, right? So to take an entry into these things, it's a very high competition. After MBBS, almost a very high demanding course now is, in today's world, is BSc Agri. Why it is so important is because, see, BSc Agri will offer you, after completion of 4 years of BSc Agri course, you will definitely get good job offers, opportunities in agricultural sciences field. You can go for higher studies in like MSc Agri, and you can also pursue your PhD there. And apart from, if you don't want to continue in that same field, you can also take up other jobs, like good jobs are offered in the defense field and also in the banking sector. So various opportunities are there, and that is why BSc Agri is a high demanding course today after MBBS, especially in the biological stream, right? And of course, BBSc, you can become a doctor of your pet animals. BBSc, veterinary sciences. BSc, horticulture, forestry. If you take up BSc forestry, you can easily clear those exams like RFO, DRFO exams. You can also go for the exams such as IFS, Indian Forestry Services. So this is also one of the courses which will offer you 4 years program, and by completing this, so much opportunities will be opened up for you, for your world of career, right? BSc Horticulture is also very important. There is a horticultural department by Karnataka state government also, and in the central government of India also. So actually, BSc Horticulture is taken up, this course is taken up by very meager amount of people, and those who go for this, so almost their job will be like almost confirmed under the government sector, right? Home sciences also will offer you so much opportunity in different fields, and so all these courses will require what? CET. And in our college, especially for BSc AG, one more very important thing for you to know about BSc AG is that, see, there is something called agricultural quota, which will be having 23% reservation. So 23% reservation for agriculturist quota, and this agriculturist quota can be applied to those students who are applying for BSc AG. And so those students, parents of such students, or the family members of such students, like immediate family member, mother or father, must be having what? The agricultural land, a piece of agricultural land. So then this agricultural quota can be expected, and under this agricultural quota, 23% reservation, if you want to take a seat under that particular reservation, you will have to clear a practical test. And this practical test will be consisting of the questions based on agricultural instruments. You will have to identify various agricultural instruments. You will have to identify various crops, agricultural crops, right? So maybe the plants or the food grains. So we will provide you such, what is that, training for practical test of BSc Agri, which is gaining lot of importance in today's world. Okay, so in our college we will give more emphasis to that particular aspect. And if you want to go for basic science study, the study of basic science, BSc, so you will get so many opportunities by keeping biology as one subject, right? So these are the combinations offered in different colleges on the basis of biology, like CBZ, chemistry, botany and zoology, CZ Micro, Chemistry, Zoology and Microbiology, CZ BT, Chemistry, Zoology and Biotechnology, CZ FSC, FSC stands for Chemistry, Zoology and Forensic Sciences. If you take up this Forensic Sciences in degree and if you pursue a Master degree under Forensic Science, you can become a CBI officer, CID officer, right? Then CB Micro, so Microbiology, Chemistry, Botany and Microbiology, CB BT, Chemistry, Botany and Biotechnology, GGB, Geology, Geography and Botany, AZFSC, Anthropology, Zoology, Forensic Science, AGFSC, Anthropology, Geology, Forensic Science, CB Genetics, that means Chemistry, Botany and Genetics, CZ Genetics, Chemistry, Zoology and Genetics, CZIF, C Chemistry, Zoology and Industrial Fisheries, and also Oceanography. And of course, these are some of the courses or some of the combinations that I have taken here. Different colleges and different universities will offer different set of combinations of these subjects. You will be having a lot of opportunities in this particular field. Then, so B Pharma and D Pharma, you can also pursue for M Pharma. So you can pursue your career in the field of pharmaceutical industries, right? Then BFSC, we have already discussed, and other streams. See, after completion of PCMB, what is the advantages of taking PCMB as the combination in PU is that, on contrary to PCMS or PCMCS or PCME, you can choose, instead of biology, you can choose electronics or statistics or computer science, okay? But what is the advantage of choosing B is, you can go for technical courses also, you can go for biological courses also. But if you opt for computer science or statistics or electronics, so this way, this door, these opportunities will be closed for you forever. So you are losing some amount of opportunities after completion of second PU. But so PCMB, if you are sure about going for engineering or technical field, then you may think of taking PCMS or PCMCS, right? So biology will offer you good opportunities like these courses. So you can also choose other streams like commerce stream, art stream, hospitality management and BSW, Bachelor of Social Work, etc., etc. That means if you don't want to continue in the science field, you can also change your field and you can go for arts or commerce fields as well. Now coming to the very important aspect, so most of you who take up biology in PCMB as one of the combinations, you will have one aim of taking an entry into medical college, medical entrance, right? So there were so many entrance exams in India like AIPMT, AFMC, AIET, JIPMER, etc. But all these exams, so they are unified and now we have got only one exam, that is NEET. So National Eligibility Cum Entrance Test. So this is the national level exam. So you, by writing this one, you can choose different colleges in a particular state or maybe nationwide. Okay, so we will provide special coaching or training for NEET exams as well in our college, right? And there is one more exam, that is AIIMS. So it is the institution, All India Institute of Medical Sciences Association. So this is an institution which will conduct its own entrance test, and this also is one of the medical entrance exams that is conducted all over India, right? So we will talk about NEET exams and AIIMS exam later in the NEET classes. And what career opportunities do I have after pursuing biology? If you take up biology as one of the subjects, if you take up biology in your further courses, degree and post-degree courses, right? So you can be a doctor, you can become a veterinary surgeon, you can become an agriculturalist. So I'm not talking about farmer. Of course, farmer is not also not a small thing. Agriculturalist means, so you can become an agricultural scientist. Then lecturer or a professor like me, researcher or scientist you can become, or you can also become a wildlife biologist. Right, these are the opportunities, job opportunities. Or if you want to continue, if you want to do something on your own using the knowledge of biology you have gained, so you can do agriculture more scientifically, you can become a scientific farmer, right? And there are many more new techniques today, like carrying out hydroponics, aeroponics, and integrated agriculture techniques. There are so many advancements in the agricultural field also. You can do that very scientifically by understanding biology. Then you can do a dairy, you can open your own dairy. What is that? Fisheries you can carry out, and sericulture, growing of silk, poultry, vermiculture, growing of earthworms and taking out good organic manure, wildlife photographer, right? Wildlife photographer, wildlife biologist. You have seen the National Geographic channels, Discovery channels, how exciting, how beautiful their work will be, right? So you can become one of them if you take up biology as one of the subjects. You can also become a plant breeder or animal breeder. So these are all the opportunities, career opportunities by taking biology. So biology as such is a very colorful subject, is a very fascinating subject, a very beautiful subject, because you will study the life here, right? So different forms of life, diversified life, so beautiful butterflies, beautiful plants, so colorful flowers, so all these things is what is biology. And that is why biology, I say, biology is not only the study of life. If you take biology seriously, biology will become your life. So biology itself can be your life if you take up biology seriously, right? So once again, I welcome you all for our SRPU campus, and thank you. Let us meet once again in the regular classes.